everybody is at different points in their journey. And if you're sending them something that's completely irrelevant to where they are in their journey, you've lost them. We all know people have got very short attention spans now. And so therefore it's crucial that you capture them immediately. You build that know, like, trust. You create an emotional connection with them. You give them value. You allow them to have that quick win, which immediately draws them into your world. All of those things can be done with a quiz. Well, specifically with the quiz results, once we've got them to answer those questions, because then we can tailor those results so that they are completely specific.
Well, I am super excited for this podcast today because we have the queen of quizzes. She is a quiz funnel strategist and a course creator, and she helps entrepreneurs grow their email list and sell out multiple six-figure launches using the power of a lead generation in a quiz funnel. So I want to welcome my good friend, Kylie Lang.
Oh, thank you so much for that lovely introduction. I'm very excited to be here.
Oh, like I said, I'm super excited. I love everything that you do, and I love that you're the queen of quizzes.
It just kind of flows, doesn't it? The quiz queen.
That's right. That's right. I need to come up with some sort of term like that. Maybe you can help me with it.
But I'll definitely give it a go.
So I want to talk about quizzes and how would an entrepreneur know if a quiz would work for them?
Okay. So first and foremost, I have yet to come across an industry or a niche that a quiz wouldn't work for. So to give you an idea, right now, I have just launched the quiz for a dating coach, and I'm currently working on the quiz for an accountant.
Oh, wow.
So very different ends of the spectrum. I also have a client at the moment who is an artist, and we are doing a quiz to help people decide which collection of her art would be right for them. I'm working with an interior designer, but really it's not so much about the industry or niche. It's more about what you know about your ideal client. So if you want to create a quiz, there's a few things you need to be really crystal clear on first of all. And the first one is, why does your business exist in the first place? Now, this should be obvious, and it sounds like it's obvious. But the thing is a lot of people can't articulate what their business does. Now, in simple terms for me, as far as I'm concerned, a business exists because it solves a problem. So you need to know and understand really well what that problem is that you solve. And it needs to be, it's usually a fairly generic problem, because then underneath that generic problem sits all of the outcomes, and the outcomes are the more specific reasons as to why that problem exists in the first place. So you need to know that. That is a non-negotiable. You need to know your ideal client inside out. What are they struggling with? Why are they struggling with it? What language did they use to describe those problems? And then you also need to have a tried and tested offer. Because at the end of the day, a quiz itself is part of a quiz funnel. And part of a funnel means that at the end of it, you're going to be selling something. So ideally, when you're putting a quiz together, you want to know what that end result is. What is it you're doing with them? Where are you driving them to? What's the strategy behind it? And what's the goal? So those two are kind of more important than whether or not you think your niche will work for a quiz. Because as I say, yet to come across a business where I can't make a quiz work like billio for it.
I really love that, because that's almost like sales 101, that you have to know your customer inside and out. You have to know what the problem is, and you need to know what the outcome is. And then that way, if you have all that information and you really know the needs and the wants of the end customer, then you can come up with the offer. So without any of that, so it makes sense that that is how, you know, a quiz, like starting off with a quiz, how that works.
That's exactly it. Because like I said, your business exists for a reason, but the reason your business exists can be different for different people. So let's say, for example, that you're a visibility coach. You help people become more visible in their business. So it's all about promotion and marketing and getting yourself out there. Visibility, mm-hmm. pretty generic.
Right.
But the reason that certain people aren't visible can be different. So it might be that the reason you're not visible is because you've got absolutely no confidence in yourself. It could be that the reason you're not visible and putting yourself out there is you don't have the right equipment. It could be you don't know what to say. What should I talk about? I don't have any content. I don't know how to put myself out there. So it could be knowledge. It could be education that you're lacking. Now, all of those things are very, very different. They sit under the same banner of visibility, but the way you talk to somebody who's got a lack of confidence compared to the way you talk to somebody who's got a lack of knowledge is going to be very, very different. They're going to want to consume different content from you. Mm-hmm. They're going to want to get different action steps, different pieces of advice. So this is where a quiz comes into its own in a way that no other lead magnet can do. Because let's face it, other lead magnets ask you for a name and email address. Bang, done. Job's a good one. You deliver a fairly generic piece of information in whatever format you want to, usually some kind of PDF, and that's it. You're not gaining any knowledge about your audience, and they're not really getting anything substantial from you either because it's generic. Whereas with a quiz, you're asking them a lot of questions so that you can target that information that you give them in the results, in your email follow-up, in your nurturing that you do after that, in the products that you send them, in the way that you sell to them, because that's another thing. If you know upfront that somebody buys on FOMO because you've asked that question in your quiz, well, that's very different to how you sell to somebody who, let's say, does all their research and likes to stalk you for a year.
That's right. Those the lurkers. Two, yes.
Yeah. They're very different types of people. Now, if you sent the lurker an email with a countdown timer at the top of it saying, this disappears in 3 days, never to be seen again, they're not going to react to it very well. They may well unsubscribe and you'll have, quite frankly, got on their nerves. However, you send them something that is much more nurturing and talks through the story of why your product exists and really brings them into your world, totally different.
It's, you know, it's really nice because the way that I look at it, the way that you're describing it is that you have, you know, the quiz is the very beginning. And then once they answer all those questions, it's almost like you're building all these separate funnels for each one of those customer types.
Yes.
And it's really a great way to nurture your customer wherever they are. I mean, that's one of the things I always teach all my folks is, you know, meet the customer where they are. So it's almost like the ultimate tool to meet the customer where they are.
Oh, and bonus, it's fun to do. They can't help themselves. So that kind of helps you to get all of that information and meet them exactly where they are in that point of their journey. And that's so true what you say there, because, you know, everybody is at different points in their journey. And if you're sending them something that's completely irrelevant to where they are in their journey, you've lost them. Mm-hmm. We all know people have got very short attention spans now. And so therefore, it's crucial that you capture them immediately. You build that know-like trust. You create an emotional connection with them. You give them value. You allow them to have that quick win, which immediately draws them into your world. All of those things can be done with a quiz. Well, specifically with the quiz results, once we've got them to answer those questions, because then we can tailor those results so that they are completely specific. Now, it's funny, just before I came on this call with you, I was brainstorming with a client of mine, and she runs a very fabulous membership for decluttering. That is what they do. So she works with hoarders and people that like to gather clutter. And we were talking about it. And I said to her, what is it that you do normally for a lead magnet? She goes, well, we've got a great podcast. I went, okay, how many seasons and episodes? And she said, we've done 252 seasons. We've had 1 million downloads. I'm like, Yeah, that's successful then. Okay.
Yes.
So what we've come up with is an idea where she's going to create a private podcast with just four episodes in it, one for each of the outcomes, because she knows her audience consume her podcast. They love hearing her on the podcast. So the idea of meeting them where they like to consume content is another way that you can use a quiz to be super powerful. So we're going to create four separate episodes that speak directly to one of those, each of those outcomes, and give them some wins, some different pieces of information that they can use and take away with them, but it's building know, like, trust. And it's also making them feel quite special because those podcast episodes aren't available on the normal podcast. Mm-hmm. It's a private podcast. So you can be so creative with this type of thing. You can not only make sure that you meet them where they're at in their journey, but give them content in a way they want to consume it as well.
That is absolutely brilliant when it comes to that. That is a fantastic idea. You got my wheels turning when you were talking about the podcast. So that's really wonderful. So do people have success? So, like, for example, with this individual, so she has, she's working with you to do a quiz for her podcast. Can you have a quiz for other things? Can you have multiple quizzes, or that kind of like burn out your audience?
No, because there's different types of quizzes. So the quiz that we just talked about is a traffic generation quiz. It's a lead generation quiz. So it sits at the top of the funnel and it's driving traffic. It has one purpose and one purpose only. That is to build your email list so you can nurture people so that when you are ready to sell to them, it becomes more of a no-brainer. So it's traffic, lead generation, email list building. That's one type of quiz. Then there's a quiz that's similar to that, but it's what we call a launch quiz. So that's an evergreen quiz that I just described there. Okay. Evergreen quizzes are great. They're always on. You can switch out the call to action at the end of it if you want to, dependent upon what you're doing. Then there's the launch quiz. Now, a launch quiz is designed specifically for one product and one product only. So let's say you were launching a new course or a new membership, or you had a new product coming out. Or a new group of products coming out, then you do a launch quiz. And everything within that quiz is just geared towards that one specific problem, that one specific element at the end of it that's going to help solve that problem. So that's a launch quiz. Then you've got a sales quiz. So a sales quiz is where you're giving people a collection of items at the end of the quiz based on the answers they've given to the questions. So a good example of this is Sephora has a really good one about choosing the right lipstick color for your skin tone. Okay. So you answer a series of questions and Sephora then give you five or six different options of which lipstick would be best for you. So it's curated products. That's the sales quiz. All of those quizzes sit at the top of the funnel. Now, then you have your middle of funnel quiz. Now, your middle of funnel quiz is an interesting type of quiz because these people are already on your list. But the point is they've already built some trust in you. They've already started to get to know you. They've been nurtured by you. They've bought in to a degree to what you're doing. So you can then create another style of quiz. Now, we did this really, really well for Andrew and Pete. Andrew and Pete run a membership called Atomic. It's like a marketing membership, quite low level for, when I say low level, I mean, it's for people probably more at that 1 to 3 year mark. So they're still learning. They're still spinning their wheels when it comes to marketing. However, they decided that they also wanted to have a program that was more of a high touch mastermind that ran for 6 months. So within their membership, they have something called the Success Predictor. It's a quiz, 30 questions split into 7 categories, and it identifies where people are in their business, covering things such as accounts, marketing, sales, general business, admin. I can't remember the rest of them, but it goes through 7 categories within their business. Now, if you scored 80% or above in that quiz, Andrew and Pete then targeted you with the Rebels program. Mm. The first time they launched it, they sent one email to those that had scored 80% or higher in that quiz, sold out the program, and generated $78,000 from it.
Wow. That is really amazing. And that, I mean, it sounds like in essence, they're just retargeting is what they're doing. And they're retargeting with a quiz.
But they're doing it in such a way that the members in their membership are being told which areas they need to focus on first. Because let's face it, when we go into a membership, quite a lot of the time, it can be a little bit overwhelming with all of the information. You think, oh, I don't know where to start. Do I start here or here or here? So as far as the people taking the success predictor are concerned, by taking that quiz and answering those questions, it's helping them to identify which masterclasses to watch first, what to do first, you know, where to begin, what their steps are. It plans it all out for them and gives them some specific advice on what to tackle next. Looking at the areas where they've scored high, then it's a certain amount of information that they get and certain copy that they're presented with. If they've scored low in certain areas, then it's more targeted with action steps, what you need to do, a little bit of the, you know, don't worry, this isn't the end of the world. We've got a masterclass specifically to help you with this problem. So it's still doing its job as a quiz by really nurturing those people in the membership and making them feel like this is an amazing membership. So it's helping with retention, but it's also giving Andrew and Pete that really important knowledge to know who are my high achievers here, who is likely to invest in this Rebels program. So that's an example of a quiz that sits in the middle of your funnel. I call that the qualifier quiz. That's the name that we use because we're qualifying them for something. Okay. Now, we've also since gone on and used this with other clients quite successfully, but we're always qualifying them for something. We've used it with the money mindset coach. And the idea is that we're qualifying them to get on a call. Mm-hmm. Now, he doesn't want to get on a call with absolutely everybody because his programs start from $10,000 and go up to $25,000. Now, he's not going to get on a call with somebody who's got $100 to spend.
Right.
So by having the qualifying quiz in there, it rules out people that are either after freebies. He still gives them some value and gives them some freebies. He also has a more entry-level program for 497, which helps us to decide who those people are. He has another program that's only $2,000, which sorts out those people. Then you've got the biggies that are going to be more ready to invest in their mindset issues and the, you know, the money program that they need to invest in to help them move on to the next level. So that's where your qualifier quiz comes in. You can use it in numerous different ways, but quite often I design the strategy because I'm a strategist. I'm a quiz funnel strategist. I am not a quiz funnel consultant. There's a difference. I'm strategy first because there has to be a strategy behind the whole thing. When we put a quiz funnel together, we come up with an entire plan for what we're going to do, and then I make it happen. We put that plan together. So for this particular money mindset coach, we did him a quiz at the top of the funnel to drive the traffic in the first place. So we'd identified what their biggest money mindset issue was, and we've started to nurture them through that. Then they go into a series of videos that have been created specifically for that one outcome. Each outcome has its own video. And within that video, he gives them things to do. He gives them exercises to show them just what it would be like to come into his world and be trained by him. And then, of course, you are faced with the qualifier quiz, and that qualifier quiz puts you into one of four particular products that you could possibly have, the freebie, the 497 product, the 1997 product, or get on a call. And that's how we separate them all out. So that has a whole strategy behind it. So there's lots of different ways of doing this and approaching it.
Yeah, no, that's a fantastic strategy. And it allows for a client life cycle as well. Because somebody may start off, you know, with the program that's down at the bottom because they're brand new. Yeah. And then as they gain knowledge and they start gaining, you know, whether it's business, you know, helping their business or whatever it might be, then they'll be ready for the next step. And then the next step after that.
Yeah. So it's nurturing them through that process.
Absolutely. So what do you do with the folks that are the lurkers that consume your content? And you know that they consume it and they do it over and over and over again. How do you get that person from being a lurker to moving on to the next step, which is what they probably want to do, but they're you know, there's some sort of mindset issue there. They're scared. There's something that they feel like they're not ready. How do you get them to move?
It comes to getting them to take what we call micro actions. Mm-hmm. So with people like that who are scared of commitment for whatever reason, and you know, there can be a variety of reasons. Now, obviously, it does come down to knowing to a degree what that sticking point is. And this is where your top of funnel quiz should have done its job in finding out what that sticking point is, because there'll always be a question in there about what's holding you back. So I have a set of questions, and I often use two questions together. You know, what would you like to achieve and what's holding you back? That's what those two questions look like in their most simplest form. That is not how it would look on a quiz, but that's what those questions mean. So we mm-hmm. already know what's holding them back. So then once we know that, we can get them to take little micro commitments. Now, a micro commitment could be something like hit reply to this email and tell me XYZ. Click on this link and vote in XYZ. Book a call is a micro commitment. It's a slightly bigger micro commitment, but there's little things that you can do throughout the nurture sequence that will start to get them to take the next step and the next step and the next step. So when they've done something like, for example, a micro commitment would be to join a Facebook group. It's a great way of being able to nurture them. Like I say, hit reply is another good one. Clicking on a link is another good one. All of those are micro commitments that are leading them to something bigger. The something bigger then comes up with something along the lines of a free webinar or video series, or in your case, it could be to come and listen to a particular podcast episode. So mm-hmm. when you have a podcast where you've got a substantial amount of episodes and you've identified that you've got four particular types of people, for example, in your audience, then you can send them one podcast episode that you believe speaks to the heart of their issue. And if you don't have one, create one, like I've suggested with my decluttering coach.
So brilliant. I love it's that strategy about the podcast. I really do.
It's another tiny micro commitment, getting them to listen to a podcast and subtly talking to them about what the next step is going to be within that podcast episode, because it's being created for them. So it's about being subtle. It's not going in with a sledgehammer and saying, buy my product now, because they're not mm-hmm. ready for it.
Oh, no, they're
all
not ready.
All these little micro commitments can be done over a period of time. They don't need to be done one day, then the second day, then the third day, then the fourth day. You spread them out. You do it gently. You get them to a point where they are so used to doing what you tell them to do that the next obvious step is to get on a call with you. And it sounds like we're manipulating them. We're not. We're giving value all the way through. We're helping them all the way through. Right,
because that's the thing. You know that you want to help them. They are part of your audience, or they're on your list, or they're listening to you somehow because they want some sort of outcome.
Yes.
And by them joining the audience or being a listener, they're raising their hand saying, I'm interested in what it is, the content that you're providing in some shape or form.
Yeah.
And so absolutely, there's no manipulation there. I mean, that's kind of like my pet peeve. There are some people that try to manipulate people in the sales process. And that's what I call slimy selling. And that's what makes selling such a bad name. And it's what you're doing there is you're just trying to get one outcome, and that's for, you know, you yourself to win, not for the customer or the client to win. It's for you to win. And so what's going to happen is that customer is not going to be with you for life. And that's really the goal that everybody should have. And I think funnels do a really great job of that too, by separating out your audience or your list into all these different like micro funnels almost that you can nurture them wherever they are. And that's one of the things I absolutely love about funnels about quizzes. So let me ask you this. Is there a topic? Somebody once mentioned this to me, and I can't even remember what their business was, but I had said something about a quiz, and they're like, oh, what I do is too boring for a quiz.
Well, let's put it this way. Accountancy isn't exactly the sexiest of subjects. And trust me, when I met Randy, who is the guy that I'm working with, I realized that I was going to be able to have quite a bit of fun with it because he's not an accountant-like type person. Right. But even so, it's accountancy. So you have to be able to make it more sexy. And it comes down to the positioning of the quiz. So it doesn't matter whether or not you have a perceived sexy type of product, for want of a better way of describing it. It's about whether or not what your product does is required by your audience. And when you create the quiz, whether you are positioning that quiz in such a way that it's irresistible to your audience because it's asking a question they need to know the answer to, a burning question they want answered, something where they feel they're going to reveal something meaningful, something that's going to help them move past whatever it is that they need to move past or they're stuck on, because that's why people take quizzes at the end of the day. So it's about how you position it. It's got nothing to do with what you offer, what your industry is, whether or not you perceive it to be interesting or not. That isn't the point. The point is your business exists because it interests certain people. So it needs to speak to that audience and that audience only. It doesn't matter whether or not I like it. It doesn't matter whether you like it. It matters whether or not those people in their audience like it and are going to take the quiz because it is hopefully going to give them the answer they've been searching for.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So can we just kind of step back into the quiz that was the list building quiz?
Yes.
So with that, can you use it in two different functions? Can you use it like in organic growth, you know, put it on in places, different platforms, or even in your email list, you know, if you have an email list, and put it there for people to take so that you can start nurturing those folks very specifically. Maybe you might have an audience on Instagram or TikTok or, you know, Facebook or any of those. And then also take that same quiz and put it for paid advertising. So let's say a Facebook ad or something like that. Does that work well?
Yes, in a nutshell. So I always say that you want to try and do a combination of both. So organic is a bit like a fine wine. It takes time to mature. It doesn't happen overnight, but it does need to be done, because when you do paid ads, they're fabulous when you switch them on. But as soon as you switch them off, bang, gone. Right. All of your promos gone. So doing together, when you're doing paid and organic together, that does work really well. And as a matter of, you know, a rule of thumb, you should absolutely be plastering your quiz everywhere. You should be talking about it everywhere. It should be your main lead magnet. It should be in the signature of your email. It should be on the profile of LinkedIn, because if you have a creator account now on LinkedIn, you can have a URL at the top of your bio on LinkedIn. That's where your quiz should be.
That's a great idea. That's,
you
know, a great
it
idea.
Should be there. It should be the first thing on Instagram. It should be advertised in the banner cover for your Facebook group or your Facebook page. And you should absolutely be doing Pinterest, because Pinterest drives traffic. Now, it's not about whether or not somebody is searching for what you do on Pinterest. It's about the fact when you type things into Google, often the Pinterest thing comes up before your actual website. So I always, when I'm working with my clients, the first thing I do when we are looking at launching a quiz is I do SEO research. Before anything else, I'm on there researching keywords. What are people searching for? What's working? What's, you know, what do they want to know? What's being typed into Google, into YouTube, into Answer the Public, all of those places? Because I want to build in my mind a list of potential quiz, not just quiz titles, but quiz descriptions, because that's what people are actually looking for, not what you think they're looking for. So that's the first place to start. Now, obviously, all that SEO research that you do not only comes in handy for the position of the quiz, but it comes in handy for writing blog posts about the quiz afterwards. Yes. And then you pack those blog posts with SEO keyword researched phrases so that you know that you're going to get a better chance of being found. Now, again, like I said, fine wine takes its time. It's not going to happen overnight. You know, those, you write a blog post, it's not going to suddenly get found in Google the next day. It doesn't work like that. But you want to give longevity to your quiz. When you spend money on a quiz or time building it yourself, you want it to work for you. Oh, so I've absolutely. Got quizzes that are still going 3 years down the line, and I don't do anything for them. I tweet the emails every now and again, but the quiz itself hasn't changed. One quiz in particular I did for the Wedding Academy, their quiz hasn't been touched in over 18 months. We built the quiz 4 years ago, still going strong, still bringing in a load of people. Now, they do run ads to it. So going back to your question about running ads to a quiz, the beautiful thing about a quiz is you're not looking to do loads of retargeting. I mean, you can, but the idea of the quiz ads is to drive traffic because you do all the nurturing within the quiz funnel itself. It's a traffic ad campaign. Traffic ad campaigns are cheaper. Plus, what you've got to remember is with iOS 14, we've lost a lot of opportunity for all that beautiful data that Facebook, YouTube, et cetera, gather on our behalf. We don't have access to that information anymore because they don't, because people have opted out. But with a quiz, you can feed that data that you've collected.
Absolutely. And you own it. The best of all, you own it.
They've given it to you. So you can feed that information back into Facebook to build lookalike audiences, which again, bring the cost of your ads down. So yeah.
That is so brilliant. Well, you've given so much information. I love, like every time I talk to you, I always learn something new.
I've been watching you scribbling away.
Well, you know what it is every time I do a podcast, I actually write notes on what did I learn?
That's
because
great.
I always think that's important from everyone, because everyone has their niche. Everyone has their area of expertise, and you can learn from absolutely anyone. And you just have to be, you know, willing to learn, willing to be open to, you know, learning, you know, new ideas and seeing, you know, because how, you know, this might come around and I'll be speaking with a customer and I'll think of something that you said that will help strengthen whatever it is, the point that I'm trying to make.
I just
think it's really important. I've been a big proponent of everyone having a mentor. And I think we all can be a mentor to each other.
Definitely. Yes. And you never stop learning.
No.
You know, knowledge is power, as far as I'm concerned. I mean, I've lost count of the amount of courses I've done. Mm-hmm. And I still do them now. I'm taking two different courses at the moment. I'm in a mastermind group because I need all of that stuff to continue to progress, to continue to learn. Things also move at an unbelievable rate now compared to what they did 10 years ago. So you have to better keep up with things as well. And, you know, your knowledge doesn't just stay static. It needs to grow.
It keeps on
Otherwise,
growing.
Yeah, you don't grow. So
absolutely.
I love that you do that.
No, absolutely. I mean, the most successful people that are out there, they're continually learning. They're continually reading. They're always in a mastermind. Same thing with me. I'm in two masterminds. And that'll let me back that up. I'm in three masterminds.
Oh my goodness.
I'm in one. They all focus on completely different areas.
Yeah.
And they provide a lot of value. But at the same time, when you're in a mastermind, one of the best things about masterminds is really the community, because you can learn so much from the other people in the community, because again, they're all going to have strengths. Like your strength is obviously the strategy and the quizzes versus mine is, you know, business strategy and sales strategy.
Yes. So
everybody has their niche that we can all help support each other. And I'm a big believer of, you know, when you put good things out there, so what comes around goes around. So when you put good things out there, good things are going to come back to you as well. And I think maybe that's one of the reasons why I've been lucky enough, you know, to get to know you.
Oh, I've really enjoyed getting to know you this year. It's been wonderful. And we've had so many great chats.
Oh, absolutely. So much fun. So much fun. So Kylie, where can people find you?
So here we go. This is what you all need to be doing when you create a quiz. You need to create a really simple URL that you can share wherever you go. So it's kylielang.com/quiz. That is where you will find me.
Perfect.
Come take my quiz and you can see what a really good quiz is like out in the wild, doing its thing, set out properly. And I'd love to know, which quiz is going to be right for your online biz, because that's the title of my quiz.
Oh, that's absolutely perfect. So everybody, again, go to KylieLang.com/quiz.
Thank you.
And take her quiz. She is just such a lovely person, and she really knows so much. She's the expert in, and of course, that's why she's called the Queen of Quizzes. So please, by all means, everyone, check her out. And thank you again, my friend, for coming on this podcast. I loved speaking with you. And I'm sure we'll be talking again, maybe on a different podcast or a summit or something in the future. And thank you again.
Who knows? But thank you so much for having me. I've loved every minute, as always, when I'm chatting to you. So thank you.
You're very welcome.